today with another The Boys reaction for you guys. And today I'm going to be checking out the album for Delicious. Well, the first half for Delicious. I'm going to be doing the first four B-sides, which are Skateboard, Lip Sync, Eyes on Me, and Door. The remaining tracks, which are OSTs, I will do another time. I don't know when, just whenever I have time. I actually wasn't planning to do the album today because I thought I wouldn't have time because it's a long album and I have other stuff to react to. I was going to do it maybe next week, but since I can just give the OST tracks a skip for now, I decided at least just to do this first half today. And yeah, I'm super, super excited. Let's just go.
Disclaimer, I will not be reading lyrics whilst listening to these songs. This is my first time hearing the songs, so I want to concentrate on the music production and their vocals, which is my priority. The lyrics distract me from that, so I'll read them later in my own time. There are plenty of reactors out there who will do lyric readings. I'm just trying to vibe. If you want to vibe with me, then cool.
Okay guys, let's go. So the first B-side is called Skateboard. Jesus Christ. This beat, that melody, that let's roll. Oh, the bass, I just came. The low register. Oh, let us sing together. Alright, love that. Oh god. Oh, it's at a 10 out of 10, but oh, summer vibes are gonna love. Let's go, this descending chord. Ah! Mm, I love it. Vocals! Vocals! Stop, that was so good. I'm gonna collapse, I'm gonna faint. What a lovely summer bop. Is this going to be a summer album? Is this going to be filled with summer bops? I have a feeling, because the title track had that vibe, and then the first B-side had that vibe. Oh my god, this also had that sort of quite nostalgic feel. Maybe it's giving me, I can't put my finger on exactly the vibe I'm looking for in this track and the title track as well. It's definitely something that's bringing me back. It's definitely given me nostalgia and I can't work out exactly what it is, but I absolutely loved it. I love that those descending sort of chords in the way it was like. Do you know what I mean? That's very, it's a very specific thing, but I really, really like that. And that little twinkly sound, that sounded so good. I loved how playful the melodies were again. Really nice vocals, really nice ad-libs as always when it comes to the boys. I love how they were sort of chanting a little bit as well. Chanting? I don't know why I said that, so British. Chanting? Still very British. Chanting? Just ignore that, bro. I love that. Okay, let's go on to the next one. Let's go, players. Don't know why I called you players. Next up, we have lip sync. Very strong bass. Ooh, I love how empty it is right now. Again. Harmonies. Japanese twang to it. Ooh, love voice chops. Very clever production. Yo, the attitude. There's I love how the beat chorus, the beat picks up. Here you go, the ad-libs. No, you should have gone again. Oh, I wish it had gone on a little bit longer when the beat picked up there for the B chorus. Do you know what I mean? Because I loved how empty the chorus was at first. And you saw it was empty and you just have that bass sort of driving the chorus. And then you had the sort of vocal chops. And the whistle, which was very, very catchy. It was a very, very catchy chorus without too much going on. Do you know what I mean? There was like three catchy moments: the whistle, the voice chops, and then the bass. right? And then I love how empty that part was, but very, very catchy. And then bang, the B chorus comes in and the beat sort of fills up. You have more stuff going on. I really, really like that. I kind of just wish at the end there we'd had it repeat one more time, because you knew it was coming. You had it coming. It was like, you knew it was coming. It comes in and then it ends a little bit too soon for me, in my opinion. But like I said, I loved how empty those parts were, where it was just very sort of bass driven. I loved the pre-chorus. Again, something very nostalgic in terms of the melodies. I really, really like that. Let's go on to the next one. Okay, guys, let's go. Next up, we have Eyes on Me. A little bit of a record quote. Piccato strings. Dum, dum. Oh, is that piccato strings or guitar? I'm confused. Dum, dum, dum.
I need a boat at time like a surfer. Nothing but and myself in the mirror. Nigga, that's it, I'm at the
the layering as well, the harmonizations. I think that's voice manipulation.
Manipulation.
Oh, that was very, very short. Ooh, okay. I feel like that one had a little bit more of a different vibe compared to the previous ones. I feel like this one was a little bit more grown, it was a little bit more mysterious, a little bit more sexy. Immediately when you had that boom, doom, doom, boom, I think it sounded like pizzicato strings, what it was supposed to anyway. I really, really like that. I love how they change their delivery. Like, I just love how they just adapt to different sounds, because immediately the way they were singing, the way they were rapping, they came with a completely different energy and flair. It was a very, very sexy song. I love the voice manipulation. Again, very clever production. I enjoyed that, not as much as the previous songs, but I enjoyed it. Let's go on to the last track. Okay, guys, let's go. Last but not least, we have Door. Oh, that sounds so good already. The Fender Rhodes. Oh, God. I'm scared. The way this is coming in. Can't talk. Those 808s. What's that really low deep synth? And if there's one thing I can depend on when it comes to the boys, it's some good old R&B with top-notch S-tier vocals. That was so smooth. That was so smooth, and they really and truly came through with the vocals. Like I said, bro, it's just one of them things. Like, I know the boys can do R&B, and I know they can sing R&B. Not everyone can sing R&B, really and truly. That was absolutely fantastic. That pre-chorus, the way that sort of, you had all those little layers with the pads and the synths, and then underneath it all, it was that really low, deep sort of synth as the bass. It sounded so good, and there was those two chords that I kept trying to point out. And then when the chorus hits and you have those 808s come in, the R&B goodness, the R&B realness, excuse moi. And I love the, you know, I love a wow, echoey, dreamy sort of synth pad, Fender Rhodesy vibes, okay? I'd have to say my favorite song on that album was between that door and Skateboard, probably. Two very different vibes, but I can't choose between the two right now, if I'm honest. Fantastic album, first half anyway. I enjoyed it thoroughly. I feel like even though we had a couple of different vibes, I'd say we had some smooth R&B and some more upbeat, fun type of vibes. I'd say overall, it is a perfect summer album. Obviously, I haven't heard the three main tracks anyway, but I feel like this is one to have on repeat over the summer from the songs I've heard thus far. Anyway, the boys never disappoint. Let me know which track was your favorite. And yeah, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, subscribe if you haven't subscribed. If you have subscribed, I love you. Gonna follow me on Instagram, guys. Gonna follow me on Twitter. And yeah, goodbye.
Oh!